गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो टुडे वी विल सी ए पोएम टॉपिक। ओके, दैट इज द फर्स्ट पोएम, डस्ट ऑफ स्नो बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट। सो दिस इज ए पोएम बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट इन बट इट कन्वेज द पोएटिक मैसेज दैट कोहेरेंटली द पोएम शोज हाउ ह्यूमन जजमेंट ऑन सर्टन इश्यूज कैन बी मिसलीडिंग। मीन समटाइम व्हाट हैपेंड, वी थिंक सम डिफरेंट थिंग एंड द कॉज इज समथिंग डिफरेंट एंड द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस इज डिफरेंट। सो हियर व्हाट हैपेंड इन दिस पोएम, द पोएट वॉन्ट टू शो द मीन्स समटाइम्स वी आर मिसलीड बट दैट मिसलीड इज कैन बी रेक्टिफाइड बाय द नेचर। सो इन द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा, दैट इज द वे ए क्रो सुक डाउन ऑन मी द डस्ट ऑफ स्नो फ्रॉम ए हेमलॉक ट्री। फ्रॉम दिस स्टैंजा द वर्ड मीनिंग्स आर डस्ट ऑफ स्नो व्हिच मीन्स पार्टिकल्स ऑफ स्नो, हेमलॉक ट्री ए पॉइजनस ट्री विथ स्मॉल व्हाइट फ्लावर्स। नाउ द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द स्टैंजा वन, द पोएट रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट रिकाउंट्स और रिवाइंड्स ए स्मॉल इंसिडेंट दैट चेंजेस हिज मूड। तो व्हाट इज दैट स्मॉल इंसिडेंट, इट सीम्स वेरी सिंपल बट इट हैज ग्रेट सिग्निफिकेंट। ओके, जनरली वी ऑल्सो हैव दैट टाइप ऑफ इंसिडेंट्स। द पोइट वॉज वंस वेरी डिप्रेस्ड एंड होपलेस, ही वॉज इन ए स्टेट ऑफ सोरो एंड वॉज लॉस्ट इन हिज थॉट्स। He was standing under a hemlock tree. Suddenly, a crow that was sitting on the tree shook the tree, and the fine particles of the snow from the tree fell on the poet. So, understand? Once what happened, the poet was very depressed, and he sat on a hemlock tree. Hemlock tree means a poisonous tree. So, see here, both hemlock tree and crow, both are negative things. One is poisonous tree and a crow, we determine it as a black, means a negative thing. So when the poet was sitting under the hemlock tree with hopeless and depressed, that once a crow, suddenly a crow that was sitting on the tree shook the tree, and fine droplets of the snow from the tree fell on the poet. Okay, that is the first stanza. Then we come to the second stanza. The second stanza is, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So what happened? Now here the word meanings are mood, a state of mind, rued, held in regret. Okay. So explanation, when the soft and cool snow fell on the poet, it changed his mood from sad to happy. What happened previously, the poet was depressed and sat under the hemlock tree, and suddenly a crow sitting on the tree shook the branches of the hemlock tree, and the fine droplets of the snow fell on poet. When the soft cold snow fell on the poet, it changed his mood from sad to happy. He started feeling soothed and refreshed. So this simple interest incident helped him enjoy the remaining part of the day. He thus became happy, as it saved his rest of the day from being wasted and held in regret. So this simple interest, think here, this simple interest, simple incidents of just a dropping of the small particle of the snow on the poet changed his mood from sad to happy. Okay. Here the poetic devices used are rhyming scheme ABAB. What is ABAB? That means you see the stanzas, stanza 1. Last is crow, then me, then snow, then tree. Means here the crow and snow, first line and third line, the last word of the last letter of the first line and last third line is same, crow and snow, and second and fourth, me, tree, that pronunciation is same, rhyming scheme. That's why it is A B A B. Is second stanza heart, then third is part. Second one is mood, then rude. Okay, this is the rhyming scheme. And here symbolism is hemlock tree and crow. Here two symbols are been discussed. One is hemlock tree, another one is crow. Now, in a short brief, I am discussing about the summary of the poem. Dust of Snow is a beautiful short poem written by Robert Frost. This poem tells that even a simple movement has a large impact on the significance. The poet has mentioned crow and hemlock tree in this poem. Crow signifies his depressive and sorrowful mood, and hemlock tree is a poisonous tree. So both are negative things, crow and hemlock tree. Both of these signify that the poet was not in a good mood. And so he describes the dark, depressive and bitter side of the nature to present his similar mood. In such a sad, depressive mood, the poet was sitting under a hemlock tree. A crow sitting on the tree shook up the dust of snow, that is, small particles of snow that remain on the surface of the snow. His day, this simple action changed the poet's mood. He realized that he had just wasted a part of his day repenting and being lost in sorrow. But the change in his mood made him realize that he should utilize the rest of the day in some useful activity. So his sorrow was washed away by the light sorrow showers of the snow dust. His spirit was revived and he got ready to utilize the rest of the day constructively. So this is the poet in all. Thank you.